Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today's topic, installing, setting up and configuring SQL Server for AutoCAD Plant 3D projects. Let's get started. In this video, we will focus on configuring SQL Server. You can find links to download SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio for free in the description. I have also included a PDF guide for installation and setup with detailed screenshots. After installing SQL Server and SQL Server Management Studio, create an instance. Open SQL Server Management Studio, choose the correct instance name, select the authentication type, and click the Connect button. If SQL Server is not connected, click the Connect button here again. To create a new login, click the plus icon next to the security section to expand it. Then, right-click on the login section and select New Login. In the Login Properties window, under the General section, choose Windows Authentication for a Windows login or SQL Server Authentication for a common username and password. If you select Windows Authentication, click the Search button. In the Select User or Group window, click on Location. If you are on a LAN, select the entire directory and click OK. Then, in the Object Name field, type the user's company email or name and click the Check Names button. This will list all email ID related to that name. Choose the correct one and click OK to save the email ID. If your email ID is not listed, contact your IT administrator. In the Server Roles section, ensure you check the DB Creator and Public options. Next, in the Status section, enable the newly created login by selecting the Grant option. To enable new user login, click the Enabled option. Finally, click OK to save the settings. Hooray! The new user has been added successfully. To use the common login name and password, enable the SA authentication, which is often disabled by default in new installations. Right-click on SA and choose Properties. In the Login Properties window, go to the Status section and enable the SA login by selecting the Grant option. To enable user login, click the Enabled option. Then, in the General section, set your password and click OK to save. After setting up the SA login, restart the SQL Server. On Windows 10 or 11, search for SQL Server Configuration Manager and open it. Check which SQL Server services are running. Right-click on each service and select Restart. Important: make sure no one is using the SQL Server database during the restart. Once the SQL Server restarts, the SA login will be ready to use. You can now open projects using the SA username and password. If you want to create your own SQL Server authentication login, enter the login name and password, then click OK. The status will be enabled by default. If not, follow the same steps used to enable the SA login. After setting up your own SQL Server authentication login, restart the SQL Server again. In Windows 10 or 11, search for SQL Server Configuration Manager and open it. Check which SQL Server services are running, right-click on each service and select Restart. Important: ensure no one is accessing the SQL Server database during the restart. That's all for today's episode. Today's tip: it's better to use Windows Authentication instead of SQL Server Authentication. This helps to determine if any issues are related to a specific user's machine or Windows login.